If you have not already done so, I'd suggest you review the segments on weathering washes. That's where we're at now. We're going to do a little bit of airbrushing on these cars to finish them off. But right now, we'll look at what I'm using. I'm using your basic Badger airbrush. It's a model 350. You don't need anything really fancy for this. I'm also using, picked it up at Lowe's, Home Depot. It's just a bottle of CO2 and regulator. Makes it easy and portable for me. Some people have portable compressors and stuff like this. This setup is a little bit expensive to start with. I think it was $90 for the initial setup. Once you own it, it's just like propane. You're taking the old bottle in, you get a new bottle, it's $9 for a new bottle of CO2. I do have a compressor and stuff, but I've actually gotten really fond of just using this bottle stuff. I can use $8, $9. It's up to you, but it's convenient, quiet, and it works. So we'll just screw the bottle on. Set her up. It's already set up. Since we're painting the undersides of the cars first, I usually either use a grimy black or an oily black. Either one works fine. Black doesn't really show up well in the layout because nothing really is really black. The grimy black is kind of a gray color. Oily black is a little bit oily color. How about that? We'll start with those and just highlight the bottoms of the cars real quick before we get into taking care of the sides. I think for today's segment, I will use the grimy black. Another item, I've talked about it before, is a stirrer. Great item. I used to be a shaker. I'll do it just to piss people off again. Shake, 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 shake. Don't do that. People get upset about that. I've done it for years. Never had a problem. Paint stores do that with house paint, but people that airbrush don't like to see that. Shake, 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 shake. So don't do that. Put the old thing in, stir it up. This does an outstanding job of mixing your paints, pulling all the pigments off the bottom. If you want, make a milkshake, I don't know. Pull it out, dip it in the, this is just water. They're just basic acrylic style paints, non-oil based, water based paint, so just dip it in there, wipe it off. Another thing neat about most of these paints is this blue liquid right here. Cleans everything. A good cleaner. I guess it's ammonia in it. Just spray stuff down. Wipe it off. For the people that don't know what this blue liquid is, if you spin it around, it's glass cleaner. Windex with ammonia. That's the key, the ammonia. Just to point it out, why you don't want to shake your paint. See all that gunk on the top and your lid? When your paint dries up there, gets all the gunk on the top, gets in your airbrush, clogs it up, leaves chunks on your models. But so that's why you don't do that. Put my airbrush up here for now. Got a little stand for it. Prep it up. Now what we're going to use is I use a little bit of this Tester's Universal Acrylic Thinner. Just a little bit of this. Drop it in the cup. Put 3 or 4 drops. Spray, whatever. Put some of that in there. Then I put about 1/3 alcohol into it. To a half. Because I really want this paint thinned out. Grab me my straw. Actually, I'm going to use a bigger straw on this one here. Standard soda straw. Drop it in the paint. Just start loading up the cup and the brush. For the people that don't see what I'm doing up the top, it's just a finger on the top. Creates a small vacuum in there, doesn't let the paint come out. Drop it up one more time. Call it good. Cap my paint off, put it out of the way. Take one of these universal stirring devices known as a toothpick. Stir it up. You know, you want this pretty thin. In fact, this is really more paint than I'll actually use for the cars that I have out right now. But the object is to get this stuff thin, thin, thin. See, it's just watery. Load her up. Open the brush up. Close it up. And these are, the mailman gives me this stuff. Somebody's really nice to mail me things in these white envelopes. Work great, I use them for all sorts of stuff, car holders. Keep adjusting it out just until you get a light mist. Now that we're back, I have the airbrush primed and loaded. I'll actually test it real quick before I actually lay a car in there. What I do is I just normally throw the car up here on the on its side. Take an index card, or one of the little fancy business things that come from your magazine. Lay it along the top. Make sure I get some paint. Yep, the tip of my brush. Acrylics, you got to be careful with, they dry really quick. So sometimes while you're messing around, the paint will actually dry on the tip. Let's try that again. Yeah, just like that.